Hello everyone, myself Rohit Vyas, lecturer, Civil Engineering Department. Today I am going to represent my lecture on wind load analysis of subject wind and seismic analysis, BTech third year, fifth semester. Previously, we covered two units. First unit was introduction of all kind of wind and seismic loads, and second unit about wind load and its related IS codes. First of all, I would like to state that this complete subject is numerical based, and total four codes are included in it. Number one is IS 875 part 1, which includes all kind of building loads which are related to civil engineering works. Another one is IS 875 part 2, which includes all kind of load combinations, including dead load, live loads, etc. and etc. And IS 875 part 3 gives a complete idea how to analyze and resolve an action of wind load subjected to a building, which is available in various shape. For an example, if there is a rectangular clad building, then wind load is calculated for walls as well as for roofs also. If building is rectangular building with pitched roof, then it is calculated for walls as well as for pitched roof. Pitched roofs are mostly located in urban, suburban areas and rural areas of India, and intensity of wind load is maximum on pitch kind of roofs. So, to start this lecture, let us know about what are the main aspects of wind load. Basically, wind load is a natural load, and according to the Indian standard, India is divided into four zones of wind, and basic wind speed is provided for each and every important districts of India, which is measured in Annexure A, page number 53 of IS 875 part 3. For an example, our district Bikaner is found in the western part of India, and basic wind speed of Bikaner is 47 meter per second. So let us start. Today our question: a rectangular clad building located in rural area with pitch roof. This is an example number 4 of explanatory handbook based on wind load analysis, which I already sent you on your mail 1 month ago. Let us discuss the problem statement. Calculate wind pressure and design force on walls and roof of a rectangular clad building with pitch roof having a plan dimension 10 meter by 50 meter and height 5 meter as shown in figure below. The building is situated in Dhanbad, Bihar, is an industrial area 500 meter inside open land on a fairy level topography. Walls of building have 20 openings of 1.5 meter and by 1.5 meter size, which we are analyzed before in previous question. The roof is of GC galvanized corrugated sheet, and the roof angle alpha is 15 degree. Calculate also the local build pressure on roofs and walls of a cladding building. The column and trusses are 5 meter center to center. First of all, I would explain what are the trusses. Trusses are the roof supporting member. which are mostly provided in these areas of building. I can try to draw it. These are the main truss showing areas, and it is basically a steel tubular frame which can used for wind load for to support the roof against wind or other kind of natural forces. It is covered by a galvanized corrugated sheet. We can known it as a tin shed in our local language. It is clearly measured that its roof angle is 15 degree. I would like to mention here is the angle. Basically it is the 15 degree angle on which the roof is situated. The actual dimensions of the building are shown in figure. Length is 50 meter, width is 10 meter and height is 5 meter. So then we have to analyze this. First, we have to collect all kind of wind data which are given in IS 875 part 3. It is clearly mentioned in the sections of section 5.2 to 5.5 of the IS 875 part 3. Let us start with, as we know that Dhanbad is the district of Bihar, and it is counted in urban areas. And Dhanbad is situated in zone 2 and the boundary of zone 2 and zone 4. For such places, higher zone is recommended. Therefore, wind zone 4 is recommended for Dhanbad, for which basing wind speed, which is clearly mentioned as here, VB 47 meter per second. Okay. And it is given in IS 875 part 3 section 5.2. Then we will go for terrain category. Terrain category defines the overall surrounding of any building, and as per IS 875, any location can classified into four types of terrain category. And as per IS code, our building is situated in transition from category 1 to category 2. Because it is situated in urban area, but it has one dimension larger than 50 meter. That's why it is in the transition state of category 1 to category 2. Then there are various design factors which we are discussed before. One of them is risk coefficient factor, which is represented by K1. This is a general kind of building for which it is always one, or clearly mentioned in section 5.3.1 of the table number 1 of the code. Another one is terrain and height factor. Since it is located in urban area, then we will consider it as one. Topography factor, Dhanbad has a fairly level topography, that's why its topography factor is considered also one. Importance factor for cyclonic region, I would like to mention that India is counted in non-cyclonic regions. Then according to which we can ignore this factor also, because it has always a value of 1, because we don't have such kind of cyclone in previous 100 years in urban areas. Only coastal areas of Odisha and Konkan land is suffering from cyclones. Then there is a wind directional factor, which is always considered as 0.9, which I mentioned earlier in the classroom and given in section 6.1.1 of the code. Area averaging factor, it is a non-hazardous building, then we will ignore this factor. Then next and important aspect to be calculated is the permeability of the building and area of the wall, which need to be calculated. Since it is a rectangular clad building, then it is calculated by simply applied by a formula of perimeter, which is 2 times width plus 2 times of length including height for all the section. Similarly, area of the all opening is calculated. As per the question, the size of each opening is 1.5 meter by 1.5 meter and these are in 20 numbers, for which total permeability of the building is 45 meter square. So if we calculate the percentage of the build permeability, which is found 7.336%, and for 5% to 20% building is of medium permeability. For medium permeability, coefficient of internal pressure is always plus minus 0.5, which is discussed after this clause. Then we have to calculate design wind pressure. As per section 5.3 of the code, design wind speed formula is Vz, Vb, K1, K2, K3, K4. We already discussed these factors K1, K2, K3 and K4 previously. When we will put all the data, then we will found the design wind pressure Vz is 47 meter per second. There is no change in the design wind speed. And as per IS code, design wind pressure is 0.6 Vz square. That is for which to overall pressure on the building is 1325.4 Newton per meter square. This thing to be remembered that there is a little bit difference in stress and pressure. Pressure and stress has same unit. Pressure is an external quantity and stress is an internal quantity. Then we have to calculate, we will ignore this PD because it is depends upon area averaging factor, which is neglected previously. Then we will directly move on wind load calculation. As per section 6.2.1 of IS 875 part 3, the wind load calculation formula is given as CPE minus CPI into area into wind pressure. CPI is the similar internal pressure coefficient, which is depends upon the permeability of the building. And as per the permeability obtained 7.336, the value of CPI is here plus minus 0.5, which is given in this note. One thing has to be remembered that when we will use CPI in positive, then CPI is always command in negative nature, because one force creates pressure and another one creates suction. Then we have to calculate external pressure coefficients by using table number 6 of roof angle 15 degree. And H, first of all, we have to calculate H by W ratio, which is 0.5 as per table number 6 of IS 875.3. Different portion is made, and as we discussed earlier, the basic wind due for wind incidence angle of 15 degree, the portion EFGH faces pressure coefficients of minus 0.8 to minus 0.6 as shown in the screen. Then we have to calculate design pressure coefficients on roof. This is quite simpler than wind pressure on wall, because it is clearly depends upon H by W ratio and L by W ratio of the wall. And there is no need to differentiate between them, because it can be clearly understood by this simpler figure. Let me explain this. These figures are basically a portion of fixed roof, and there are maximum probability of wind incidence on roof portion of the building. As we know that similar direction angle represents addition of the force, and opposite direction arrows shows opposite direction of force, and the resultant is shown in right hand side of the portion. These wind forces are calculated for 0 degree incidence and 90 degree angle for all EFGH zone. And after that, a maximum positive and negative forces are count from this, and when we will put these forces in F, then we will found our final pressure force on roof. Then we will go on design pressure coefficient on wall, which again depends upon S to the height to the width ratio and length to the width ratio of the building, and for which table number 4.2 is given and angle of incidence is given, which is clearly mentioned in IS 875 part 3 clause 6.2.1, and we can directly put our data from there and apply these into our formula given for wind force calculation. Then it will clearly gives you a value of pressure and suction for different portions of wall A and B. There are another aspect to calculate local pressure coefficients of design of cladding and fasteners. It is basically a load subjected to the fasteners or and the joints of the roof which are subjected to wind. Then as per IS 875 for roof angle 15 degree, wind is subjected on only ridge portion, gable portion and corners of the fall, which are shown in negative value, which clearly represent that these forces create suction in the roof, for which when we calculate the total suction, then for ridge portion and for the edge portion, it will clearly calculated as -1.7 to -1.5 as shown in figure. Therefore, wind pressure for this fastener is calculated, which is clearly very low in nature, 1.193 kN per meter square. Therefore, on the last of this video, I would like to mention this question is very important for exam point of view, because as per previous papers, this question is repeated more than 10 times. And I will request you, please go through it and learn through it. Thank you. Jai Hind.